Good morning, everyone. In the last video, we discussed a problem related to polar plot. Now, let's continue with some more examples related to polar plot. You see, in the last lecture, we took GSHS is equal to like K divided by S plus 1. K divided by S plus 1, right? And for this transfer function, we found that the polar plot becomes like this. Here we have K, this is imaginary, this is real, this one is minus 180, this one is minus 270, this one is minus 90, and here we have omega is equal to 0 and here omega is equal to infinity, right? This is our polar plot for this GS. Now, if a pole is added to this function, now what will be the polar plot? So, let's start. First, G J omega H J omega is equal to K divided by J omega plus 1 J omega plus 2. And the magnitude will be equal to K divided by under root omega square plus 1 and under root omega square plus 4. And angle theta will be minus tan inverse omega minus tan inverse omega by 2. Now, find the value of m and theta for omega tends to 0. What will be the value of m for omega tends to 0? As omega tends to 0, magnitude becomes k divided by here under root 1, so 1, here under root 4, so 2. So, this becomes k divided by 2. And what about theta for omega 0? This will be 0. Right? And as omega tends to infinity, what is the value of m and theta? Limit omega tends to infinity m and limit omega tends to infinity theta. As omega tends to infinity, m becomes 0, and as omega tends to infinity, this is 90, so minus 90 minus 90 minus 180. Now, what is the form of our polar plot? What is the form of our polar plot? Now, the starting point is omega is equal to 0, and at omega is equal to 0, angle is 0 degree, means we are on this line only. And on this line, magnitude is k by 2. Since here we have k, then k by 2 will be here. K by 2. right? As omega tends to infinity, m is 0, magnitude is 0, but angle is minus 180 degree. In this case, angle was minus 90 degree here, k divided by s plus 1. This is the polar plot for k divided by s plus 1. And as we increase, as we add a pole in this function, now the polar plot ends at omega is equal to infinity, at m is equal to 0, and at this time angle is minus 180 degree. It means this will end up like this or like this. Right? This will end up like this or like this. Right? Now, if the polar plot will end up here, then this will be like this. And as the polar plot end up here, then this will be like this. Right? And in both the cases, the polar plot intersects the imaginary axis. The polar plot intersects the imaginary axis. So, first of all, find the intersection of the polar plot on the real and imaginary axis. For that, change this function in real and imaginary term. So, g j omega h j omega will be like 1 minus j omega, 2 minus j omega. So, this will be 2 minus omega square minus 3 j omega divided by multiplied by k divided by 1 plus omega square 4 plus omega square. Right? And this polar plot intersects the imaginary axis when real part of this g j omega h j omega is 0. So, by putting real part to 0, we get 2 minus omega square is equal to 0. It means omega is equal to under root 2. Omega is equal to under root 2, which is equal to 1.414. And at omega is equal to under root 2, what will be the magnitude? M at omega is equal to under root 2. Here, this will be 2, 2 plus 1, 3, under root 3. Here, this will be 2, 2 plus 4, 6, under root 6. So, is equal to k divided by under root 3, under root 6, right? Or k divided by 3 under root 2. K divided by 3 under root 2. So, k divided by 3 root 2 will be something, means this point is k divided by 3 root 2. And what is the angle? Angle theta when omega is equal to under root 2. What will be theta? Minus tan inverse root 2 minus tan inverse 1 by root 2. Minus tan inverse under root 2 minus tan inverse 1 by under root 2, or I can say that minus tan inverse root 2 plus tan inverse 1 by root 2, and this term is the 90 degree, so minus 90 degree. Tan inverse x plus tan inverse 1 by x will be equal to 90 degree. It means polar plot intersects the imaginary axis on minus 90 degree line and at magnitude k divided by 3 by 2. So if this value is k divided by 3 by 2, so the polar plot intersects here only, not at this point, because this is the minus 270 degree line and this one is the minus 90 degree line. Therefore, the polar plot will be like this, right? This is our polar plot. So you can see that as we increase the pole, as we add the pole, the polar plot ends here. Means if I compare this case and this case, we see that for single pole, the polar plot ends in a single quadrant. For double pole case, the polar plot ends in the two quadrants. The polar plot consists of two quadrants. It starts from here and end in this quadrant, right? मतलब ये है कि जहां एंड होना है पोलर को, जहां एंड होना है पोलर को ओमेगा इज इक्वल टू इंफिनिटी पर, तो वो पोजीशन आपका एक क्वाड्रेंट आगे बढ़ जाता है. अब अगर हम एक पोल और ऐड करें तो ये एक क्वाड्रेंट और आगे बढ़ जाएगा. एंडिंग स्टार्टिंग तो यहीं से होगी, लेकिन एंडिंग एक क्वाड्रेंट और बढ़ जाएगा. अब हम एक और केस लेकर देखते हैं, एक जीरो ऐड करते हैं, s प्लस 3, s प्लस 3, तो यहां क्या बन जाएगा, j ओमेगा प्लस 3, j ओमेगा प्लस 3, एंड इन दैट केस, in that case magnitude will become here omega square plus 9, omega square plus 9, angle will be little change in the angle will be here, plus tan inverse omega by 3, plus tan inverse omega by 3, right? Now, what will be m if omega tends to 0? जब omega 0 होगा तो m क्या बनेगा, यहां से 3 बाहर आ जाएगा, 3k by 2, 3k by 2, और angle क्या बनेगा, now the angle becomes 0 degree only, angle becomes 0 degree. मतलब अभी भी स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट यही है, अभी भी स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट यही है, बस थोड़ा सा यहां से आगे शिफ्ट हो जाएगा, ये 3 बाई 2 के हो गया, मतलब यहां पर आ जाएगा, ठीक है, 3 बाई 2 के हो गया मतलब और आगे चला जाएगा, ठीक है ना. As omega tends to infinity, then what will be m and theta? As omega tends to infinity, m becomes infinity. M becomes infinity, right? Or we can say that it's not infinity. It is like, since here we have omega square and here we have omega power 4, then this will be 0. What will be the angle as omega tends to infinity? As omega tends to infinity, this is minus 90, this is minus 90, this is plus 90. So, angle is minus 90. Angle is minus 90. Right? Angle is minus 90. Now, real and imaginary term or intersection point means polar plot starts from 0 and end up to minus 90 degree. Polar plot start from 0, angle 0 and end up to minus 90 degree. So, polar plot will be like this only. And where polar plot intersects the imaginary axis and real axis. So, break it into the real and imaginary term. This will be, first multiply this 3. So, 6 minus 3 omega square minus 9 j omega plus j 2 omega minus omega cube minus rather plus 3 omega square multiplied by k. And the real term becomes this 3 omega square and this 3 omega square will cancel out. It means the polar plot intersects the imaginary axis at omega is equal to infinity. And the polar plot intersects the real axis. If I put this value to 0, then minus 9 plus 2 minus omega square is equal to 0. So, this is minus 7. And this is imaginary value, or we can say that the polar plot never intersects the real axis except this 3k by 2, right? It means the polar plot will be like this. So, what we see, if I add a pole in the system, the polar plot will end in a next quadrant. If I add a zero to the system, the polar plot will end in the previous quadrant, right? जब हम एक पोल ऐड करते हैं तो जो एंडिंग होगी पोलर प्लॉट की एक बढ़ जाएगी एक क्वाड्रेंट, और अगर हम एक जीरो ऐड करते हैं तो जो आपका एंडिंग होगा वो एक क्वाड्रेंट घट जाएगा। ठीक है ना। टेक द नेक्स्ट टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन, टाइप वन। टाइप वन सिस्टम, फॉर टाइप वन सिस्टम दिस इज लाइक दिस, के बाय एस, एस प्लस वन। नाउ इन दिस केस जी जे ओमेगा एच जे ओमेगा इज इक्वल टू के डिवाइडेड बाय जे ओमेगा प्लस वन, and the real imaginary term, what will be the real imaginary term, minus of 1 minus j omega, so minus 1 plus j omega k divided by omega under bracket mein omega square plus 1. This is the real imaginary term. मैग्नीट्यूड के डिवाइडेड बाय ओमेगा अंडर रूट ओमेगा स्क्वायर प्लस वन, एंड व्हाट विल बी थीटा, थीटा विल बी माइनस 90 डिग्री फॉर दिस जे ओमेगा एंड माइनस टैन इनवर्स ओमेगा फॉर दिस टर्म। नाउ as omega tends to 0 m and as omega tends to 0 theta, what will be m and theta? As omega tends to 0 it is clear that this is infinity, as omega tends to 0 theta will be minus 90 degree. Now limit omega tends to infinity m, limit omega tends to infinity theta, what will be m and theta as omega tends to infinity? So it is clear that as omega tends to infinity m is 0, and as omega tends to infinity theta is minus 90 minus 90 minus 180, right? Minus 90, minus 90, minus 180. Now, find the intersection point. For intersection point on real axis and intersection point on imaginary axis, so real intersection imaginary part will be 0. Omega k divided by this term is 0. So this will be in the polar plot will intersect the imaginary, the real axis when omega is equal to 0 and when omega is equal to infinite. Omega is equal to 0 and omega is equal to infinite. And imaginary intersection, imaginary intersection के लिए क्या करेंगे, real part को 0, then this is the polar plot intersects on imaginary axis only on omega is equal to infinity. So let's draw the polar plot. the polar plot will start from omega is equal to 0, which is m infinity. This is imaginary, this is real. This line is for minus 90 degree line, and for omega is equal to 0, the angle is minus 90 degree. So we are here, and here the magnitude is 90 degree. Sorry, magnitude is infinity. And from here our polar plot will start and end up to minus 180 degree, and m is equal to 0. Right? And the polar plot will intersect the real and imaginary axis at 0 and infinity only. It means the polar plot will be like this. The polar plot will be like this. Now, we find that this polar plot intersects the imaginary axis and real axis on only on omega is equal to infinity, that is m is equal to 0 and angle theta is equal to minus 180 degree. Similarly, in the previous case, if I add a pole here, then what changes will be there? If I add a pole here, then G J omega H J omega will be J omega plus 2. Right? And after multiplying the conjugates of these two, we get 2 minus omega square minus 3j omega. And after multiplying minus j, for minus sign, this is omega square minus 2 plus 3j omega. And when I multiply with minus j, then this will be minus 3 omega plus j omega square minus 2. Right? So this will be like 3 minus 3k omega plus jk omega square minus 2 divided by omega within bracket omega square plus 1 omega square plus 4. And what will be the magnitude and angle? Magnitude will be k divided by omega under root omega square plus 1 under root omega square plus 4. And theta will be minus tan inverse omega by 2. As omega tends to 0, m again infinity. As theta omega tends to 0, theta again minus 90 degree. Means for type 1 system, the polar plot will always start from this point. For type 1 system, the polar plot will always start from this point. Right? Now, as omega tends to infinity, this magnitude is 0. And as omega tends to infinity, angle will be 90, 90, 90, minus 270 degree. As I told you earlier, that as I increase the pole, as I add the pole, the ending of the polar plot will extend in the next quadrant. So, similarly here, the polar plot will end here, like this. Polar plot will start from here and end here, right? So, we have to find this intersection point. For real intersection, make the imaginary term 0. This imaginary term will be 0. And the imaginary term shows the polar plot will intersect the real axis at omega is equal to infinity and omega is equal to under root 2. Omega is equal to under root 2. And this will intersect the imaginary axis. This will intersect the imaginary axis when real part is 0. It means when omega is 0, when omega is 0 and omega is infinity. When omega is 0 and omega infinity, this will intersect the imaginary axis. Right? So, at omega is equal to under root 2, what is m? At omega is equal to under root 2, what is m? As I put under root 2, this is 1 by root 2. From here, root 3 and from here, root 6. Means 1 by 3 into 2, 1 by 6 means k by 6. K by 6. And what is theta at omega is equal to under root 2? Theta at omega is equal to under root 2. Here, this will be tan inverse root 2. This will be tan inverse 1 by root 2. Again, this is 90 degree. So, 90, 90, 180 on this line, minus 180 degree. On this line, this value is k by 6. And this is our polar plot. This is our polar plot. Right? Now, if I add a 0, then again the polar plot will be like this. Again the polar plot will be like this. Right? Similarly, for type 2 system, if I put here two poles at the origin, then this will be like square and the real imaginary term will be 1 minus j omega, so minus 1 plus j omega, minus 1 plus j omega, divided by omega square, plus 1, divided by omega square plus. And magnitude will be here square and angle. If this is j omega square, then the angle will be for j omega square minus 180 degree. This is our angle. As omega tends to 0, magnitude will be infinity. As omega tends to infinity, magnitude will be 0. As omega tends to 0, angle will be minus 180 degree, and as omega tends to infinity, angle will be 180 and 270 degree, right? And now, the polar plot will be like this. The polar plot will be like this. Right? Polar plot will be like this. And the intersection point, if I find, then what will be the intersection point on the real and imaginary axis? On the real axis, the polar plot will intersect at the 0 and infinity. And on the imaginary axis, the polar plot will intersect on the infinity only. Right? Now, if I add a pole here, then what will be the polar plot? So, from our previous solutions, we can expect our polar plot after adding a pole like this. So let's see if this is true or not. Here we'll have j omega plus 2, and here in the denominator there will be omega square plus 4, and in the numerator, if I multiply the both, 3 minus omega square minus 2 minus omega square minus 3 j omega. And from here, I am having only minus sign, So, minus sign will make it positive. So, this will be omega square minus 2 plus 3 j omega k omega square minus 2 plus 3j omega. Right? Magnitude will be, one term we'll add here, omega square plus 4, and one term we'll add here, tan inverse omega by 2. As omega is 0, m is infinity, omega infinity, m 0. Omega 0, angle minus 180, and omega infinity, angle will be 270 plus 90. This is 360. Minus 360. And where is the minus 360? This 0 line is nothing but minus 360 degree. Plus 0, minus 0 is the same line. Plus 360, minus 360 is the same line. Plus 180, minus 180 is the same line. Right? Now, where is the real intersection? For real intersection, make the imaginary term 0. After making imaginary term 0, I find that omega is equal to 0 and infinity. And for imaginary intersection, we put the real term 0, and after putting the real term 0, we find omega is equal to under root 2, and at omega is equal to under root 2, magnitude will be, from here I am getting 2, root 3, root 6, so 3 to ja 6 root 2, k divided by 6 root 2. and angle at omega is equal to root 2, here 90 degree, here 180 degree, something is missing, a knot. For root 2, this will be 270 degree. 270 degree, right? Minus 270 degree. So, the polar plot will intersect the imaginary axis at this minus 270 degree line, and at k by 6 root 2, the magnitude value. The polar plot will start from omega is equal to 0, that is m is equal to infinity at minus 180 degree line, and will end up to omega is equal to infinity at an angle minus 360 degree and magnitude 0, right? So, in this way, we can sketch our polar plot. I introduce you the polar plot for the three types of the system, the type 0, type 1 and type 2 systems. Similarly, you can draw polar plots for any open loop transfer function. Now, if I have to find the phase margin, gain margin and stability by using polar plot, phase margin, gain margin and stability by using polar plot, then we must draw a unit circle. We must draw a unit circle and look at the critical point. And look at the critical point. So, phase margin gain margin and stability by using polar plot. So, this topic we will discuss in the next video, right? Thank you.